Hi and welcome back to PR Tech Talk. In my latest video I showed how to install Visual Studio Code, and the reason for that is ST have announced that they have making some changes in their policy and focusing more and more on Visual Studio Code. They do not abandon STM32Cube IDE, that still remains. But since that is their case, I thought that we should maybe then dig into more on Visual Studio Code. I will make a project on CubeMX and get that up and running on Visual Studio Code. If you haven't installed Visual Studio Code already, take a look in this video and follow the steps and tag along back to this one afterwards. If we go down, we hit this STM32Cube and we then hit Launch STM32. MX, and we also installed CubeMX in the form video, so that one should also pop up like this. Now that STM32CubeMX has launched, I have decided that I will make my application on a Nucleo board. I hit access to board selector. Here is the board selector, and I will then write Nucleo U5. Select that one and we have it there, and we can just start the project. I just select generate demonstration code, and I'm also selecting that it will use all these that is already in the BSP. That is the user LED, that the user button and the virtual COM port. So we don't write any code at all in this project. When it has done loading, we can just hit the project manager and we can make a project name for us. And then also you need to point out the project location where you have your workspace. And then the crucial thing here, that is the really crucial thing. You need to make a CMake program, a project out of it, otherwise it won't work. So keep that in mind, CMake there. And we just hit generate code. Now it's done, it has created a project under this path. We can just close CubeMX and go back to Visual Studio Code. We go up under File and Open Folder. Here I found under ST Workspace my project VSC Blinky1 that I just created. I just mark that one and I choose Select. Just be a bit patient, and eventually there will turning up this small notice. Do you want to configure this project? And you should answer yes in this application. And by now you can also connect your development board, and it says as device detected ST-Link V3 and open devices and boards view. I will just hit that one. There we have the ST-Link debugger, so now he has track on that one as well. Then when it's loaded, I do like this. I hit this icon again, and I hit then the setup STM32. You can see it's down here also the project that we opened. So we hit the setup. You need to define which board you have and the tool chain, that is the GCC. And we configure it for debugger version. Great, so now everything is done there. We can try to build a project. And it built complete, and we can then also try to download the code to the Mac controller. And this is the first time, so we haven't created a JSON launch file. So we hit that one, and we select then the ST-Link GDB server in this case. It has created that for us. We can just close that one and ask it, and then we will save it. Hit run and debug again. And then we have a new green icon up here. We'll click that one. Now it will start downloading the code to the microcontroller. And there it stopped on the HAL init. What this code does, when it starts, it prints out on printf, welcome to STM32 world. And then it goes down to this while one loop and it waits for the button to be pressed. And when the button is pressed, it will toggle the LED. We hit this start debug and it downloads the code to the microcontroller. And it breaks on the HAL init here. And then I will also bring in a PATTY. We have a terminal and the baud rate is 115/200. If we then just run the code, we see that we have this welcome to the STM32 world. And we can also see on the board there that green LED is turned on. And whenever I then press the blue button, toggles that one. It doesn't, however, make any changes to the terminal. And if we want to make some alteration to the code, I made a small change to the program, so whenever the button is pressed, it also prints out the print the button is pressed on the terminal. We build a program, and then we download it to the microcontroller. And we run the code. So just to start from the very beginning, we hit reset. It says welcome to STM32 world. And now whenever I hit the button, it just says button pressed while it's also changing. So that is how we create an STM32CubeMX project in Visual Studio Code with their SDK 3.5. This ends this session. Hope you liked it. If you did, please give me a like. If you have comments to give me, please put it in the chat below. And if you're not a subscriber, it doesn't cost you anything. Just hit the button. See you in the next video. Stay safe. Bye.